These days you don't have to look very far to come up with someone sinking the boot into the ALP. Occasionally even party heavyweights have been lining up. Cue former New South Wales Government Minister Frank Sartor, a man once tipped to be state premier. He didn't make it, and now in a new book, the former mayor of Sydney has dropped a gigantic bucket on his old Labor mates. I spoke with him earlier. Frank, good to talk to you. You haven't pulled your punches with this book, have you? It's hard to believe that a guy who was a Labor minister has been prepared to say these things about a Labor government and a Labor party.
Well, I haven't said everything there, but I've said enough to give people an idea of what was going on, yeah.
Yep. Actually, your subtitle, I think, probably says more to most people than The Fog on the Hill, How New South Wales Lost Labor Lost Its Way. I'd go further and say they've lost the plot and that goes for probably Labor in the rest of the country as well.
Yeah, there's a chapter talking about losing the plot. They have lost the plot. I think that we've ended up with some significant changes in the party. I mean, basically they've lost the ability to follow the rules of good government. The rules of good government are that politics follow good policy, that you've got to implement things properly, that you've got to be transparent, that you've got to be competent.
But isn't it more the case, more profound than that, that they've almost forgotten what being Labor means? They need a remake, almost a new name, a social democratic party or something, because nobody really knows any longer what the Labor Party stands for.
Well, I think that's true. It's because of the way people have got there, the careerists. I mean, the reason why I've written this book is not because some people made errors or we got voted out of office, that happens, or I didn't get some of the things through that I wanted to get through. That's okay. The reason I wrote the book is this mindset, this attitude. These people just don't want to engage. It's sort of like a superficial career path.
Do they have an ideology any longer?
Well, firstly, let's not generalise. They're not all the same, but the significant number of people at the senior level, I don't think, have an ideology at all.
You listed all the things you thought were wrong with them. You think they've reached rock bottom, was your term. Factionalism, shoddy deals, incompetence, short-sightedness,
patronage.
Floundering, backstabbing, patronage, personal denigration. Other than that, not a bad bunch of blokes. I mean, is there anything right about them?
No, let's be clear. I pointed out what's gone wrong with the relationship with the unions, what's gone wrong with the party machine, what's gone wrong with the caucus, and then therefore the cabinet and the leadership. That doesn't mean that everyone throughout the system is bad. There are some good people there, absolutely some good people. The problem is that the people allocating the power have sort of lost the plot.
And the Labor brand, as a result, is on the nose.
Is very much on the nose. And that's why when you get put in new premiers or new leaders or new prime ministers and you say, I'm a new person, we're okay now, unless you're a Bob Hawke that had a huge brand or a Keating or a Howard or a Rann or maybe a Carr, your own personal brand isn't going to subsume the Labor brand. You've got to fix up the Labor brand.
What I've got to ask you is, why haven't you just you spat the dummy because you thought you'd end up premier and it didn't work out that way, so you're now putting a bucket on them?
If you read the book carefully, and I know you're a busy person like you probably can't read every word.
Carefully scanned.
You would see that when you actually look at the way I write it, I actually explain why I say what I say. And people that have read the whole thing, people, Labor historians like Rod Cavalier, don't think that it's about bitterness at all. And can I say this? When I lost the Labor leadership, I was the most relieved person in the universe because we were heading for a hiding. It would be a poison pill.
Were you ever really a true believer?
No, I think I absolutely do believe in Labor.
Or an opportunist.
No, I believe in Labor, absolutely believe in Labor values, absolutely. I grew up in a very poor family. My background was, we struggled, it was very difficult. I understand all that. I wasn't in the Labor Party for many years, but then I worked in communities and I got elected as mayor many times.
Still
a
Labor
grassroots
man?
Stuff.
Still a Labor man now?
Absolutely, still a member of the Labor Party, still a Labor man now. I would like to see them do well because, you know what, they're much better for the country. Potentially, or have been in terms of their values, if they follow the script, they're much better for the country than the alternative.
How political of you. Thanks very much, Frank. Good to talk to you.
Pleasure.